is somewhere that would. A city that embraced the new. Paris. Wave after wave of artists had made their way here. Impressionists, cubists, dadaists, and now the surrealists. He and Georgette moved here in 1927. The French surrealist, led by André Breton, admitted him to this most exclusive of artistic movements. But always the nonconformist, even this was a club that he didn't really want to belong to. I've come to the Magritte Museum in Brussels to find company.
It was very stimulating in terms of his creative output. He painted over 100 pictures in 1 year, but he did not fit in because he didn't believe in this whole notion of the unconscious and that you can tap into the unconscious. He said, oh, I hate when my paintings are interpreted in terms of the unconscious or in Freudian terms. He was into philosophy and philosophy of language and the philosophy of representation, particularly with games like this, where he shows that actually the word and the image aren't necessarily related. Let's have a look at Sissi, Continue, De Ne Pas Être, Repeat. This continues not to be a part. And it's really interesting. Look at it. Can you smoke this pipe? No, you can't. So this is not a pipe. He shows how unreliable language really is and how slippery language is.
And if you turn around, you can actually see some of them here, E.L.D. Maisons, and also Paul Collini and Irene Amor. They all met here and discussed how the artistic development would go. Magritte was experimenting at the time with different styles, and I think he actually experimented with whatever style he could get his hands on, until he comes across this painting. This is Songs of Love by Giorgio de Chirico. And de Chirico was a metaphysical artist. De Chirico thought of it as trying to see something from a different perspective. Life with a clairvoyant, there is another level of perception. That was a moment of revelation to Magritte. And it moved him to tears.
Chirico ne s'inquiétait pas d'une manière de peindre, mais de ce qu'il faut peindre, ce qui est très différent.
Magritte realized that really what is important in painting is the idea rather than the form. So what kind of idea does it convey? And how can he represent ideas to challenge our habits of thought? And we can see this in his first surrealist work, The Lost Jockey.
C'est la première toile que j'ai vraiment peinte en ayant le sentiment que j'avais trouvé ma place.